This is an Israelite Jewels recording.
The Sealed Book of Mormon. Words of Moroni. And now behold, I desire to speak unto those who shall have the words of this book in their hands, after the Lord has stretched forth his arm upon the Gentiles in the latter days. For, behold, there shall be many of the Gentiles, and also of the Jews, that shall not harden their hearts concerning the words of this book which Nephi prophesied, when this book shall be revealed unto the children of men, and written unto the book. But, behold, many shall believe the words of this book, and rejoice to know that it proceedeth out of the hand of God, and from their eyes will fall the scales of the darkness that prevents them from seeing in their fullness the truth sent from the heavens to the children of men, and before many generations pass, they will begin to coalesce in true knowledge, and they will become a pure and pleasing people in the sight of the Lord upon all the inhabited earth. And it shall come to pass that the Lord God will again begin his work among all nations, tribes, tongues, and peoples, to effect in these times, already appointed by the Lord, the full restoration of all things, of which God spake by his servants, the prophets. Therefore it is in these days that the Lord invites his people, "Come to me, O ye Gentiles, and I will show you things greater than these. Yea, the knowledge that is hidden because of the hardness of their hearts. Come to me, O ye house of Israel, and great things shall be revealed to you that the Father has reserved for you from the foundation of the world and have not come to you because of your unbelief. Behold, the time has come for you to tear this veil that leads you to remain in this terrible state of iniquity and hardness of heart and blindness of mind, for the words that come from this record, the Sealed Book of Mormon, are like the hard tip of the mallet that shatters the hardness of the rock that covers your hearts hardened by your traditions and is the fire of the refiner who refines and purifies the filth of his thought stained by the precepts of men. In those days the Lord will stretch out his hand a second time in order to reclaim his people, who are of the house of Israel, and to do a marvelous work among them for the purpose of remembering the covenants which he made with the sons of men, and to fulfill the promises made to Nephi concerning the descendants of Lehi, his father, in order to recover the remnants of his seed and so that the words of this book, written by the seed of Nephi, come to the seed of his father in the last days and to the knowledge of the house of Israel. Behold, I am Moroni the son of Mormon, and my father was a descendant of Nephi, who was the son of Lehi our patriarch, who was the son of Shaphan, coming from a family of scribes of the kingdom of Judah, and of the tribe of Joseph, by the seed of Manasseh, just as one reads in the genealogy of Lehi by his own record described in the first part of these plaques that my father Mormon compiled. Shaphan was the scribe secretary of King Josiah in the days when Hilkiah the high priest found under the altar of the temple in Jerusalem the ancient records of Moses, and among them the book of the law and the sealed book itself of the things that Moses saw when he was snatched to heavenly Zion. And it came to pass in the first days of the reign of Zedekiah, for how much Lehi returned from Babylon together with Gemariah, the son of Hilkiah, when they were jointly commissioned by the king of Judah to go to Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and they took with them a letter from Jeremiah the prophet destined for the elders, the priests and the prophets, and all the people exiled in the land of Sinir, that the Lord appeared to him in a pillar of fire, and after that event he was no longer called by the birth name Elasa. But he became known by the name that God called him, Lehi, which corresponds to an abbreviation of Eliasib, whose meaning is, by means of whom God restores. Behold, I, Moroni, am the same as I told you before, that if possible I would make known all things. But I was instructed to seal my father's records and with it the record that the Lord asked me to write about what the brother of Jared saw, because the things he has seen are beyond the understanding of the Gentiles until they repent of their iniquity, and become pure before the Lord, and begin to exercise faith in the Son of God as did the brother of Jared. Nevertheless, I was commanded by the Lord to separate into three sets a whole record contained in the plates of Mormon in order to be revealed in three periods of times. The first set is a preparatory appendix of the second, and the second of the third. The first serves to constitute an alliance between God and the Gentiles through repentance, and constitutes an open record, to be given in preparation for the people to understand the greater things when they will be revealed. And if they do not harden their hearts when the second part comes, they will not only know the mysteries of God through the first part, but will receive more, a little here, another little there, line upon line, precept upon precept, until they know the mysteries of God through the revelation of the second part, to the understanding of all things concerning His church in the last days. But the reverse will come to those who possess the first part of the records compiled by my father, Mormon, in the last days, yea in the days of the Gentiles, but who will not be willing to meditate upon it in their hearts, so little will avail themselves of the gifts superimposed on a promise transcribed by me, Moroni, and which corresponds to the first two parts of my father's writings, since I have registered these my words as an exhortation, before even sealing these records, corresponding to more than one sealed record, because at no time did I say this record when I mentioned that I would be sealing these records. And I exhort you again, if God deems it prudent for you to read these records, if you have only the desire to understand the truth about them and from your heart meditate on their words, then I exhort you to ask God, the Eternal Father, in the name of Christ, if these things are not true, and if you ask with a sincere heart and with a true intention to know, having faith in Christ, then He will manifest to you the truth of them by the power of the Holy Spirit, for through the Holy Spirit you may know the truth of all things. And it shall come to pass with those who harden their hearts to this second part, when it shall be revealed unto the children of men, that even the knowledge of the first part will be taken away from them and they will remain attached to the precepts of men. They will honor the Lord with their lips, but they will be far from His ways. They will be convinced of their faith in the first part previously revealed of these records, saying, "We have enough, and we are not ready for more scriptures." From this will be taken even what little of the knowledge they have until they have nothing left but their traditions. In turn, the set corresponding to the second part which I, Moroni, foretold in a double prophecy revealed to me from Jesus Christ, whose context exposes both the emergence of this book sealed of Mormon that must be revealed before the coming of our Lord in the sight of His disciples in the last days, as well as the record of the seven seals that my father, Mormon, foresaw in this record, that our Lord alone is worthy to open the rest of the seals which He contains in the sealed set of these plates of Mormon, through the events which were foretold upon the nations of the earth after their coming upon Zion and the New Jerusalem and the seven events which will henceforth unfold with the children of men, all foretold in these records, which by it Jesus Christ will be revealed to those who will have the faith of the brother of Jared, before the coming of heavenly Zion and the tent of God be established forever among the sons of man and the kingdom of our Lord subdue all nations under His terms. For it was revealed to me in this mixed vision that I obtained from these final events, that before the Lord came to unveil the fullness of His mysteries, that the revelations which the Lord had made to be written by His servant John, should be manifested in the eyes of all the people before His coming. And that these revelations, transcribed by my father, Mormon, in these sealed records, should serve as a reminder to the covenant children that the work of the Father truly began over all the inhabited land. It is at this time that the Lord calls His people to repentance a second time and invites them to come to Him in order to believe in His gospel. It is at this time that the word that the Lord revealed to me, Moroni, is fulfilled, when He said, "Behold, when you tear this veil of unbelief that leads you to remain in your terrible state of iniquity and hardness of heart and blindness of mind, the great and marvelous things which were concealed from you before the foundation of the world will be revealed to you. Yea, when the revelations which I have made to be written by my servant John were manifested before the eyes of my people before my coming, then shall ye know that the great and the wonderful work of the Father truly began on the whole face of the earth, so that all men may for the last time repent, even to the ends of the earth if they so desire, and come to me, Jesus Christ, and believe my gospel, before I come to my temple and delineate the boundaries of my kingdom, where there will be those who are loyal to me, and no one will be allowed to cross their borders. On this day alone in Zion there will be protection, and in the New Jerusalem a refuge for the fellow citizens of the saints. Also in those days when the things I selected are revealed, about which I wrote that they should not be touched until such time as God judged it prudent to reveal these things in the future, then in that moment when they are brought to light by the one who is to read the words contained therein, it will occur just as in the previous days of times, that this other man of whom I have written, that he will have the privilege of showing these plates to those who will help bring this work to light. Initially they will be shown to three by the power of God, who will know with certainty that these things are true. And through the mouths of these three witnesses these things will be firmly established. And no one else will see, except a few, according to the Holy Spirit, and they shall testify together with the power of God, also by His word, first uttered by the mouth of the ancient prophets, of whom the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit will testify against the fallen and ruined world in the last days. As for me, Moroni, the Lord made me see when I was projecting the seals for these plates, which should contain two cylindrical metal pieces that would transpose all sealed set of plates. But with two internal heads to contain the remainder of the plates, where there will be another six heads of seal, according to the circumstances that Christ will reveal them in the times designated by Him, after His coming at the temple in Zion. Behold, this, come after this book of which I have spoken, which shall first be revealed to the Gentiles, that they may repent of their abominations and sins, and so shall there be still other records in this set of plates which shall remain united by these two inner heads, and must be sealed again by the one who will write the record of this first part, because not everything will be revealed in his days with the opening of the first seals, in order to preserve its content so that he will reveal the rest of the plates when the Lord finds it prudent in the future, when in the end, the children of the covenant, which will come after the translation of this first set to regroup in a single fold under the name given to His chosen ones, for which your church should be known in the last days. Then the Lord shall descend from the heavens with sounds of trumpets accompanied by a chariot entourage, and horses and wheels of fire, which shall cover the heavens as the clouds cover the earth, and all the nations that have pierced Him shall feel ashamed, and the people of the world of mankind, being afraid, shall flee without direction from their dwellings, and as reptiles, shall hide themselves in their slits, and a storm will sweep the four corners of the earth as if by a strong wind that would fill the four corners of the sky, when finally the Lord comes down in His temple, not to bring peace among the nations, but to annihilate those who ruin the earth, yea, to set fire to the chaff, bound in bundles, which are churches in the field of the world, for His wheat shall be sheltered in His vineyard, in the harness of the Lord, in Zion. After these days of great uproar among the nations of the earth, the Lord will come to His temple and redeem His church to make it a holy property and give it an eternal name, rescuing what was formerly lost, Church of Christ, and establishing His people perpetually upon His everlasting gospel. I, Moroni, I gave continuity in writing and compiling the records given to me by my father Mormon. It was then, when my father was 65 years old, that he found himself tired to pursue his record, for how much his hands have lost the vitality and the fingers the sensitivity to carve the characters in the metal sheets, and at night, under the light of the lamp, his eyes weakened with the reflection of the plates. It was then that my father, Mormon, decided to hide the records on Mount Cumorah after taking them out of the library of Shem, all records previously compiled by him from this place, except for these few plates that contain a summary made by my father, and the other 24 plates found by the people of Lumi in the days of Mosiah in regard to the Jaredite record, and that I have been entrusted to complete their work for inasmuch as the other records assigned to him by the hand of the Lord, beginning with the plates of Nephi, along with the books that my father examined, and which constitute the records of the prophets, from Jacob to King Benjamin, among which my father had chosen to finish his resume, together with the records which were sealed by the ancient prophets and preserved by the hand of the Lord for a wise, future purpose. Among the account made by my father of the plates of Nephi, among them is the record of Lehi, the patriarch who came from Jerusalem, the records of Nephi, the son of Lehi, the record of Jacob, the son of Lehi, the record of Enos, son of Jacob, the record of Jerem, the son of Enos, and the record of Omni, the son of Jerem. From the plates which were selected by my father and which the prophecies concerning the coming of Christ have been fulfilled even to our day, beginning with a brief introduction transcribed as the Words of Mormon, is found condensed in summary the record of Mosiah, the record of Alma, the record of Helaman and other records with the name of Nephi, and three other records which were employed by my father and me as the Book of Mormon, the Book of Ether, which contains a record of the Jaredites, extracted by me, Moroni, from the 24 plates of the people of Lemmi, except the part of the vision of the brother of Jared, which I have transcribed from the rest of the 24 plates, but which will not be revealed until the Lord comes to his temple to purify the sons of Levi, and the book I wrote soon after, which bears my name, as the Book of Moroni, from the sealed records of the prophets, which were summarized and compiled on this set of plates by my father, Mormon. Among them is the sealed book of Moses, written by the hand of Moses himself in scrolls of hides, and which had been sealed by his signet ring, and which was later compiled on the plates of the people of Nephi, which contains the records of the prophets, containing the things he saw concerning this world and the prophecies concerning the judgments of God that would fall on the inhabited earth, each in their respective dispensations, for how much King Josiah himself did not endure these prophecies, whose record was found together with the book of the law, when Hilkiah, the high priest in Jerusalem, undertook the restoration of the temple, coming to consult Huldah, the prophetess, to know if any of these terrible events described in the sealed book of Moses would have to fall upon the chosen nation of his days. But of all records of Moses, my father Mormon compiled only a summary, leaving aside the prophecies and pointing to a wise, future purpose, the issues related to the Melchizedek priesthood among the covenant people from the beginning to the end of all preconceived times, for how much the remaining content of this book of Moses will be on the plates that will be revealed only when Christ comes to his temple in the last days. Therefore, it was in the care of the family of Lehi, whose name was Elasa, before the Lord called him, for inasmuch as his father Shaphan, as well as his forefathers before him, was the secretary and scribe of the king of Judah, and with that he was acquainted with the language of his ancestors and also of the Phoenicians, as well as of the Chaldeans, from which Abraham proceeded, and also of the Egyptian writing, for how much the Hebrews were taken captive by Pharaoh after Joseph perished in Egypt, until Moses delivered them. Thus, Lehi had been commissioned by the Lord to protect this record of Moses, and directed to cross the great water soon after returning from Babylon, when in the early days of the reign of Mattaniah, which had been given the name of Zedekiah, he was sent with Gemariah, son of Hilkiah, to Nebuchadnezzar with a message from the king of Judah. It was at this time that Jeremiah the prophet sent to the care of Elasa, that is, by Lehi, a letter to the chief elders of Judah and Jerusalem who were exiled in the land of Babylon. And it came to pass, therefore, that this record of Moses was again sealed by Shaphan, the father of Lehi, after the order of Josiah, the king of Judah, for the posterity of Israel, and his seed, as set forth in the record of Lehi, for insomuch that his writings were hidden by him and his brethren, in a cave that lay between the mountainous plain of Mira, east of Sidon, and which was later required of Lehi to bring with him to this land of promise. And it came to pass, when Lehi was commissioned, that when he was overpowered by the Spirit of the Lord, he was shown the sealed book of Moses, which he would have to protect, and that he was required to read his pages, thus coming to understand that which his father Shaphan had read years before to King Josiah concerning the destruction of Jerusalem, when he rent his garments before the prophecies described by the great Moses, which were to occur in all ages until the coming of the Messiah, and after him, to the consummation of the fullness of time. Thus, with the other records on the brass plates from the beginning to Jeremiah, they were required by the Lord that Lehi should bring them from Jerusalem to this land of promise. Nevertheless, over time, the very book of the law, except for the sealed book of Moses' prophecies, had been transcribed in many brass books with the wise purpose of the Lord for the days of King Benjamin, which were distributed among the priests of the people of the Nephite nation, that they might remember the law of the Lord, and might teach the people to keep themselves holy before the heavens. For this reason, it was that my father, Mormon, summed up among the two books of Moses, only the one that had been sealed and which had never been revealed to the children of the covenant because of their iniquities. In turn, only those who truly believed and sought to know the mysteries of God, and received Him, received this knowledge, however, it was forbidden to divulge them. And now, that record which in ancient times had been sealed by the great prophet Moses, is summed up in these sealed plates of Mormon, to be revealed only at the appointed time of the Lord. In addition to the sealed book of Moses, there is the record of the Acts of the Three Nephites, written by Jonah, one of the sons of Nephi, who had been chosen by Jesus to be the chief disciple of the 12 whom he called. Also, there is a summary of the prophecies of Samuel the Lamanite, which were fulfilled among my people, written by Nephi, at the command of Jesus for the purpose of reminding the people of the covenant in the last days, before the coming of the Lord into his temple. Lastly, one third of the record of the revelations of John, written by the three Nephites, for insomuch that they saw these things revealed by an apostle of the Lord, whose name was John, when they were caught up and transfigured before the throne of God were shown unto them all things unspeakable from the mysteries of heaven, but because of the commandment which they received in heaven, to keep this knowledge sealed, they did not report it because they ministered among all the inhabited earth, but recorded the things which they saw and heard to be revealed, when at last these things start to occur again between the sons of men, when finally, these things begin to occur again among the sons of men. Lastly, it was left for me, Moroni, to make a record of the ancient inhabitants who here on this earth came before us and who were dispersed in the course of the fall of that great tower, at the time when the Lord confounded the language of the people in the days of Nimrod, which are recorded in the record of the 24 plates found by the people of Lemhi, among which, I gathered a part with the plates that were selected by my father, in relation to the record of this people which I called the people of Jared, for how much I briefly summarized his history as the book of Ether, who had been the last Jaredite prophet who existed on the face of the earth. The other part, which regards the writings of the brother of Jared, which also appear in these 24 plaques selected by my father Mormon, had originally been made similarly to Nephite writing, in which one can read more than one word per character, which allows to occupy the full space of the plates, however, made according to the Jaredite writing. It was then that I, Moroni, compiled the remainder of these plates in Nephite writing, using them to transcribe the rest of the report in the same pattern, to which, the Lord commanded it to be clustered to the sealed records of my father. However, I did it with a mixture of letters, both Nephite and Jaredite. So I did according to what the Lord showed me, to remain some symbologies of His holy and sacred order among all the writing of this book, that in later days of times, will serve as signs to understand the power of that faith that I, Moroni, would like to show the world, but which will only be possible according to the decrees of the heavens, to be revealed only after the coming of Christ in His temple, when finally, men exercise their faith equal to that of the brother of Jared. Notwithstanding, although the writing of this record, which bears the name of the brother of Jared, being the book of Mori and Cumer, should remain sealed, together with the rest of the revelations of John in the sight of the seer when these things begin to occur, after the first seals are opened. Being that among these few things that will be drawn from the first sealed set, before being every book put together in a later period of time, will be sufficient to awaken the faith in the followers of Christ who will proceed from this great and marvelous work that will take place when these things begin to take place among the covenant people in the fullness of times, that the Lord may stretch forth His hand for the last time, that He may redeem His people that are of the house of Israel, will happen then, that the Book of Mormon will be, as prophesied by the prophets, opened in three periods of time, to begin with the arrival of the time of the end, when then, the Prince of Darkness was ruling the earth in those days, but will have no power over this land of promise, so that there will be on this earth the opening of the first determined time and a light shine in the darkness forever upon the sons of men and from there on, many will seek true knowledge. And having passed 1290 days since the continual sacrifice was removed before the altar, then, As regards the remnant of darkness, a light from distant lands will shine from afar on the holy people of God with the opening of the first seal, and a period of appointed times will begin, when many will be cleansed and whitened and approved, but the wicked will certainly continue to act wickedly, and none of them will understand, but the insightful will understand. Blessed are those who will remain faithful until the arrival of the 1,335 days when the third and last book is opened by our Lord and our Advocate together the Father, yea, Jesus Christ. Amen.